Today, I will answer 10 crucial questions about a drug that is very commonly used in my specialty, rheumatology, called hydroxychloroquine or known as Plaquenil. This is a medication used for patients with arthritis like rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, and Sjogren's disease. If you are struggling with arthritis or you know someone who is, watch this video or share it with someone that might need this information. Let's begin.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
What is hydroxychloroquine or Plaquenil? Hydroxychloroquine, often known for its brand name Plaquenil, is a medication commonly prescribed for patients with mild forms of rheumatoid arthritis, but also with lupus and Sjogren's disease. This medication modulates the immune system and reduces inflammation in your body by stopping your immune system cells to be very reactive. It is not causing immunosuppression, but rather will influence how much inflammation is created in the body as a response to something foreign, like a bacteria or a virus. What is the effect of hydroxychloroquine in patients with rheumatoid arthritis? Rheumatoid arthritis is an autoimmune disease that can cause high levels of inflammation that will affect your joints, but also other organs like your eyes, your lungs, and heart. Hydroxychloroquine plays a crucial role because it has the power to decrease the immune system cells that will attack and in this way will lead to less inflammation. Is hydroxychloroquine a pill or an injectable medication? Hydroxychloroquine is administered orally and it's available in a tablet form. Plaquenil tablets, they can come in various strengths, including 100, 200, 300, and 400 milligrams. It is recommended to take hydroxychloroquine with food to tolerate the medication better. You may take the dose all at once or divide the dose in two. What are the most common side effects? Patients taking hydroxychloroquine may experience several common side effects, including gastrointestinal issues such as nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Other reported side effects are headaches, changes in the skin color like hypopigmentation or white spots on the skin, retinopathy, which is the eye disease, and hemolysis, which means the breakdown of the red blood cells, muscle myopathy, hypoglycemia, which means that you have a low blood sugar, weakness, and sometimes nervous system symptoms such as dizziness, fatigue, headaches, and irritability. Can hydroxychloroquine be combined with other medications? Hydroxychloroquine can indeed be combined with other disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs or DMARDs such as methotrexate, leflunomide, sulfasalazine, or even with biologic therapies. However, it is crucial to consult with a rheumatologist to discuss and tailor therapy to your needs. How common is for hydroxychloroquine to affect the eyes? Eye issues related to hydroxychloroquine occurs in 1 to 10% of patients, with retinopathy being reported at a frequency of 4%. However, the retinal toxicity is dose-dependent and time-dependent, and it will manifest after a long period of time of hydroxychloroquine use, usually more than 5 years after the initiation of treatment. Different experts have different opinions. After an eye exam for baseline, when you start therapy, some experts will recommend annual exams, annual eye exams, while others will recommend to follow up after the first 5 years with an annual exam. I personally recommend to my patients to have an eye exam at baseline when they start therapy, followed by every year's exams, especially if they wear glasses. How to monitor if hydroxychloroquine is safe for your body? Monitoring the safety of hydroxychloroquine involves baseline and periodic tests, and this includes a complete blood count, liver function test, kidney function test, and other tests like markers of inflammation. Regular eye exams are crucial and should be conducted, as I said, at baseline and every year after you start treatment, and especially if you have already 5 years of treatment. In addition, monitoring for potential cardiac side effects may involve EKGs, assessing muscle function, and periodic checks of serum electrolytes. Can hydroxychloroquine affect your organs? Hydroxychloroquine has the potential to impact various organs. Skin issues such as hypopigmentation or the white spots when you expose to the sun can occur. At higher doses and after long-term therapy, there is a rare possibility that this medication to affect your heart, causing arrhythmias, syncope, or heart failure. While it is extremely rare, liver injuries have been reported with this medication, so I do recommend caution in patients that have a liver disease. Regular monitoring and prompt reporting of unusual symptoms is essential for early intervention. Can I get vaccinated while taking hydroxychloroquine? Vaccinations are recommended for all patients with rheumatoid arthritis, including those on hydroxychloroquine therapy. Common vaccines like the flu vaccine, shingles vaccine, and pneumonia vaccine are encouraged. Ideally, vaccinations should be done before starting therapy, but they can also be given while you are on therapy with this medication. Is hydroxychloroquine safe for pregnancy? Hydroxychloroquine is considered safe for those females that plan to become pregnant and may be actually beneficial during pregnancy, especially for patients with lupus. However, it is recommended to plan pregnancy during a period of low disease activity. And while hydroxychloroquine has been shown to have no major side effects on pregnancy, the ongoing data collection is in progress and it's important to monitor your baby during treatment. Breastfeeding is generally considered also safe for patients that are taking hydroxychloroquine. Now it is your turn. Share your thoughts in the comments below. Have you or someone that you know have experienced hydroxychloroquine therapy? If you find this video helpful, like, share, and subscribe for more autoimmune diseases and medication information. Remember, this information is just a tool, not a medical advice. You should always consult with your physician for a more personalized guidance. Until the next time, take care.
RheumatologistOnCall.com